Hey, what's up guys, KS Kiral here. So this is the quick overview of Ubuntu 21.10, which has packed with new features, improvements to the user interface and performance. So what's new in Ubuntu 21.10? Now, if you are coming from Ubuntu 21.04 or 20.04, you will find a major difference in terms of visual improvements. Now let's start with the GNOME desktop. Now Ubuntu 21.10 uses a GNOME 40 as a default desktop, which brings a plenty of changes to the GNOME shell and the new design along with a brand new gestures that improve the user workflow. Now unlike other GNOME 40 distros, the moment you log in into Ubuntu 21.10, it's going to take the desktop directly instead of the workspaces overview. Ubuntu team has added a persistent dock that is present on the left and works better with horizontal workspaces and app launcher. Now this kind of looks very neat, but instead the dock on the left, when you move it to the bottom, that looks much better and adopts the horizontal workflow. With GNOME 40, the user interface may look completely different compared to a previous versions. It now introduces a brand new workspaces which are aligned horizontally. By pressing the super key on the keyboard, it takes you to an overview of workspaces where you get to see all of the running applications that belong to each workspace. You can create as many workspaces as you want based on the demand of your workflow. Now by pressing the app grid icon from the bottom right, it takes you to the all new app launcher where you get to see all of the installed applications. The app launcher is a combination of applications and also shows the thumbnail preview of all the workspaces on the top. Now this way you can open any application from here and you can also glance through into any workspace and switch to it very easily. Now, Ubuntu team has decided to bring a major theme improvements to the system. Now, inside settings, under the appearance section, there is only two options you can see to customize the theme, the fully light and the dark versions of the Yaru theme. Now the built-in applications have been updated to the latest version like LibreOffice and the Thunderbird Mail. Now Firefox browser shipped as a part of a snap package, which is kind of weird and takes some time to launch the application initially. Also, Ubuntu 21.10 has brought a few upgrades to the toolchains like GNU C compiler, glibc and LLVM improvements and more. The all-new Ubuntu comes with the Linux kernel 5.13, so which adds a support for newer chips from Intel and AMD, and adds a basic support for Apple Emulator. It also includes a new and updated drivers to support a more hardware devices, improved file systems, and tooling updates. Now keep in mind, these are not an exciting features to an end user unless if you're having a specific hardware in your computer to take an advantage of this kernel. Now with Ubuntu 21.10, the main archive is going to use a ZSTD compression. Now ZSTD is a lossless data compression algorithm designed to be used in real-time compression scenarios, which can unpack the packages during an Ubuntu install faster than the current compression tools XZ and ZZIP. Now this indeed is going to speed up the installation process of the Ubuntu by some margin compared to the previous release. Now these are some of the brand new features that I have noticed in Ubuntu 21.10. Now other features include a Wayland enabled for NVIDIA users, multi-touch gestures for laptop users, and more. Now overall, I would say Ubuntu 21.10 is only supported for a 9 months, and apart from GNOME 40, this is not a major release. So, should you upgrade to Ubuntu 21.10? Well, I would say if you are running an LTS release of Ubuntu, it's better to stick with that and wait for the next major LTS release from Canonical. Now, if in case you're running an Ubuntu 21.04, then you can upgrade to a 21.10. Now, to upgrade from Ubuntu 21.04 to 21.10 without any data loss, now head over to the settings. Now, from the About page, select Software Updates, then choose an Updates tab. Then change Notify Me of a new Ubuntu version to for any new version. And that's it. Now, once it's done, now pressing the Alt plus F2 will bring up this a pop-up. Now here you can type this command. Then the Update Manager should open up and tell you about the new version. Now from here, you can upgrade to Ubuntu 21.10 by following the on-screen instructions. And that's pretty much it. What do you guys think about it? So let me know in the comment section down below. Thanks for watching this video. It's been KSKRL. I will see you in my next one. Bye-bye.